When I was a little boy, I usually wondered what people meant when they talked about destiny. For the most part, when people talk about destiny in the culture where I grew up, it means what God has programmed. Nothing can change. But there is a problem. Whenever I watch soccer as a young boy, I usually see how 11 people struggle so hard to create their own destiny. In a soccer match, all 11 people who are in a team would spend 90 minutes to fight and struggle, to look for chances and defeat their opponent. It's by their struggles, tactics and hard work that they win. This is not to say that man wins because he works hard. This is not to mean that man wins in life's game because he's smarter than everyone. It only means that man has a duty, and if he fails in his duty, God cannot help him. Think about your destiny like a heavy object on the ground. You need both hands to carry this object. It doesn't matter how much your right hand wishes to carry it. If your left hand doesn't support your right hand, you cannot carry this object. God is your right hand. You need him, but he is almost always helpless if you fail on your part of the deal. So humans essentially have important duties in fulfilling their destinies, just as a soccer team would lose if they get to the field and fold their hands or not work hard enough. Humans will fail if they fold their hands or do not do the right things. In today's video, I am going to be sharing with you the 3 F's which determine your destiny in life. If you're new here, consider subscribing so that you won't miss other interesting videos like this. 1. Foresight. I like to watch Shark Tank because it helps me to have a better understanding of how entrepreneurs who are more experienced decide which business is a good idea and which is not. Knowing Mark Cuban from Shark Tank makes me like to listen to him. In one video, I heard him saying, "I spent my last decade asking myself where is the world going and how can I be there first?" People who win in life can see ahead of others. Because these people can see ahead of others, they can plan against what is ahead, and that is why they win. It's called foresight, and it's like having 4 eyes. When you're able to have some insight as far where the world is going, you can win big when other people fail. Let me give you a personal example here. One day, about 18 months ago, I searched Google for this keyword, the most popular website in Nigeria. It was out of curiosity. I simply wanted to know which websites people visit most in my country. But I was surprised as I saw YouTube in number 2, just after Google. What surprised me here is the fact that browsing data could be slow and expensive in my country. If internet speed is slow and data is expensive, why are people spending billions of minutes on a video platform? This got me crazy for many days, and I arrived at the answer. Media has shifted. TV may not have died, but the day of burial is announced. Radio and newspaper might still be relevant, but the hired killers have been sent for them. The new media platform for the world is the internet, and knowing that prompted me to start a media company that operates 100% on the internet. It's called foresight. You can know where you're going and prepare to be there first. You cannot win without it, and you can hardly lose with it. 2. Faith. Stephen Curry said, "To excel at the highest level or any level, really, you have to believe in yourself." You probably have heard this said a million times, but you need to hear it again. No man ever hits the target he doesn't set, and no man sets higher targets than his level of faith. Faith is the compass that directs the ship of our lives. People who have great faith in themselves have great aims. Yes, these people often fail and make terrible mistakes. In fact, many times, these people don't get what they shoot for, but all of the time, they get more than what they deserve. Here is an example from my personal life. When I was preparing for my entrepreneurial journey, I spent some days daydreaming about how I might end up becoming a billionaire, and sometimes thought I could have millions sitting in the bank in my 30s. Now, I'm in my 30s, and I don't have millions sitting in the bank, but guess what? I simply don't need that dream in the first place. In fact, what I have now is more than what I deserve. It's like shooting for the moon. Many times you might not get the moon, but you will end up finding yourself among the stars, which is actually more than what you deserve. Faith determines people's destiny, And this is not just faith in God. Every man needs to believe in his ability as much as he believes in God. Because if you believe in God and don't believe in yourself, you won't dare life or attempt great things. Apostle Paul said, "I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me." David said, "I can kill Goliath because God has been helping me to kill lions before." These people believe in God, but they also said, "I can do it." You have to say, "I can do it," and believe you can to win in life. Believing you can do something doesn't guarantee that you will have an easy life. In fact, the opposite is the case. When you believe that you can do something really big, you'll try, and because it's bigger than you, you'll make mistakes, fall, and fail. Your life will not be easier, but it will be richer. 3. Fear. Yesterday, I decided to listen to the audiobook of The Art of Public Speaking by Dale Carnegie. I've read this book about 12 years ago, and it helped me in the polytechnic as a political leader. Now that I'm planning to show my face to you, more on that later, I thought I should read that book again to renew my public speaking skills. So I was listening to the book. So Dale, while writing about the fear of public speaking, wrote something like, "Every great man experiences fear. They just handle it better than the rest of the people." That is the truth you should never forget. Fear is like blood. It's red and every human has it. Fear is in all of us, but most people don't know how to use it for their good. Your inability to act or the ability to act in the face of fear determines your destiny in life. Use fear to kill fear. Then someone might ask me, "How can I act despite the fear I'm feeling?" I have a simple strategy that works for me. I use fear to kill fear. This is how it works. About 12 years ago, when I decided to be an entrepreneur, like every human, I was afraid. What if I fail? What if I lose my business? What if I destroy my life? What if and what if? That was fear. But there was another fear, a more powerful fear, and that is, what if I spend the rest of my life doing the job I hate? Think about that. It is fearful to start a business because you can fail and crush your life. But there is even a bigger fear. You can work in a company you hate for 40 years. You can work with the people you hate for 40 years, and you can hate every day of your working life for 40 years. To me, the latter fear was greater than the former, and what that means is, as humans, we always go with the lesser evil. So starting a business becomes the best option. I bet you can apply this simple formula to everything that makes you fearful. You can use fear to kill fear. You can let your mind see how not doing what you ought to do is even more dangerous than failing at it. Here is the summary of this video. You have a significant part to play in your destiny. But those parts will be determined by how much you're able to deal with fear. I advise that you should use fear to kill fear. Faith in your ability will allow you to believe that you're capable of great things. This conviction will push you to attempt great things and achieve what most people cannot even believe is possible. Foresight helps you to see where the world is going so that you can be there before everyone else and win big. I hope this helps someone. We love you.